Have you ever thought about how you might offer a custom experience to your Zoom participants even before they enter the room? Stick around to find out how to turn your Zoom waiting room into a branding masterpiece. Hey, entrepreneurs and business owners, we know that a first impression really matters. And sometimes when you're meeting someone in Zoom, that is the first impression that they have of you and your business, because it might be the first time that you've both met, kind of quote unquote in person. So today I'm going to walk you through the steps on how to customize the waiting room experience for your visitors. Because every moment that your client or prospect is in the waiting room, you can enhance your brand awareness and add value. So let's jump in. Okay, so now I'm going to record my screen to show you how to set this up in Zoom. So first things first, you need to log into your Zoom account. And I've already done that here. And then I'm going to go over to click on my account. And then on the left-hand side here, we're going to go to settings. And then on the right-hand side or at the top, we want to make sure we're on meeting. And then if we go right here to waiting room, you have to make sure that this is turned on. Just like that, all you do is click on it. And then if you go down here to edit options is a few more admin things. So who should go in the waiting room? Is it everybody? What order should they be in? That kind of thing. But what we want to do, this is the fun part. We want to customize our waiting room. So here you can see that we've already customized it a little bit for our clients. So up here will be your video preview so people can see themselves. And then the topic will automatically show up here. So just be mindful when you set up the meeting what the topic is, because it will show up here. Then it says waiting for the host. But here's where the customization comes in. So right now you can see here I've selected a logo and description. So I put our logo in here and then I put a description that just says, thanks for being here. We'll be right with you. In the meantime, get a free copy of our resource, Double Your Income with a Marketing VA here. So now I've given them something that is going to move them one step closer to becoming a client. Or if they are a client, it might be an additional resource for them to have. Which is always a good thing. We always want to make sure that we get things in their hands, so to speak. So all I had to do here was upload the image and just select that image and put it here. Now, the other thing I could have done here would be maybe to put a picture of Kirsten and I. Okay, so something to be mindful of right here. We got a little warning that the image cannot be more than 1 megabyte. It should be a JPEG, a PNG, or GIF. And then the minimum width is or height is 60, but it cannot exceed 400. So now I'm going to replace this. Now, when you come in here, it might look just like this. So you may want to have a picture of yourself and your business partner, as the case here might be. And that's because you might want people to make sure that they understand that they are in the right place, that they are meeting with the person they expect to be meeting with. Now, if you wanted to change the copy, you could do that right here. You can see up here, the title is thanks for being here, we'll be right with you. And that's what shows up here. And then this is the description. So this shows up underneath. And obviously this could say, so happy you're here. If we were recording a podcast episode, it might say, hey, please make sure you have your microphone and your earbuds all ready for our meeting. We can't wait to have you as a guest. So I'm just going to show you what the other options are. So this is what normally the default, this is what people would normally see. And you can customize this little you can customize this section. Thanks for being here. We'll be right with you. And you can see that's right up here. So if I just said, we are happy you're here, it's save. Okay, so the default screen, if you wanted to change it, you could change the title up here. And then you could always use just an image. So it's a little different than the logo and description because you can put an image up here at the top. So this is a small image with some text on it. But if we went down here, we might want to upload an image that's a little bit bigger, that shows up bigger. And it's always a good idea to go ahead and do this and then save it. And then it looks right here that maybe we want to leave some extra space at the top of the image because it's getting cut off a little bit. So it's always a good idea to upload it and then have a look. And then you can always, like I said, go into Canva and make some edits to the image. Now, this could be an image of a book if you're an author. could be an image of podcast that you have. It really can be whatever type of image that you have or that you want to put here. The important thing to remember is that you may have the same waiting room for different meetings. So one might be, you know, your group coaching call, and one might be for a podcast interview, and one might be for just a one-to-one chat. So you may want to keep it a little bit generic, maybe just the logo and description, so that you can use it for all meetings instead of having to change it each time. Entirely up to you. If we wanted to, while we were in here, if we wanted to add a video right here, we could click on a video and then upload the video. So now when someone's in our waiting room, they could watch a video, and it's only 19 seconds. You don't really want to make this too long and drawn out. Hi, this is Jeannie from Six Figure Business Coaching, and we are so excited that you're here in our Zoom waiting room. Thank you for your patience. We'll be with you in just a few minutes. We just have a few more things to get ready so that we are fully ready for our time together. So thanks again. We'll see you in a few minutes. So did you see that? Short and sweet. It doesn't need to be anything more than that. And I even made a few mistakes in there. So you could either have your marketing VA edit that out, or you can leave it in just to make it a little more natural. So that is the way that you can customize your waiting room. So that's a wrap on this video. With these easy steps, you can now enhance your visitor's experience from the moment they click join. As a business owner, every time you interact with a client, whether it's you personally or if they're interacting with your brand, it's an opportunity to bring your uniqueness. It's an opportunity to showcase your professionalism. And now your Zoom waiting room can be a testament to that attention to detail. If you found this tutorial helpful, and I certainly hope that you did, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. And if you know someone who does use Zoom rooms, please share this with them so they're able to customize their waiting room as well. Thanks so much for watching. This is Jeannie Wilson with Six Figure Business Coaching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.